Oh, hey there. Don't you hate when people do that? Act like they had no idea that they were going to be talking on here. But this is the first part of the Solo Music Gear ST Strat. I was getting into some intense builds. I just needed something to relax. My son's 9. His birthday's coming up. And he came up to me. He never asked for anything. He's a good kid. And he said, I know what I want for my birthday. I want you to build me a guitar. So I started looking around the shop. Of course, I've got bodies and necks everywhere. And I was going to just put a parts caster together for him. He wanted the Stratocaster body styles, what he wanted. And I said, you know what? He's a good kid. And he put so much thought into what color he wanted and everything else. I'm just going to building one. So I ended up getting a Solo Music Gear kit. And so far, I'm really liking it. The body. We're going to talk about sanding. When you sand, I went through the grits from 180, 220, 320, ended up on 400. I have an aluminum bar as well I use. But when you're doing the face of the guitar, or the back of the guitar, you definitely want to use a nice flat sanding block. That's going to ensure a nice flat surface. You're really not going to notice it a whole lot until you start doing, you know, putting the pick guard. The pick guard's going to have a nice fit. It's going to be a lot cleaner guitar. Certainly, you can sand it down to some 320 with your hands and spray it. But you're going to get out of it what you put into it. And so I've got this down to 400 grit, sanded really nice. It had sanding sealer on it when it arrived. And so it was kind of hard to tell exactly what I had. It kind of seemed like a pretty rough body, because it had so much sanding sealer on it. But after sanding it, man, this thing, you know, I paid $119 just for the kit. I have paid that much just for a body, and it wasn't quite as good as this. This is, man, I'm really, really into this body. I really like it. Now, after I got it down to 400 grit, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to use the color tone StuMac. Maybe we'll do talk about that a little bit, but I'm going to do a vinyl sealer. That's going to keep the paint from soaking into the wood. It's going to help keep the wood grain out. It's going to give you a nice mirror finish. That's why you take it down to 400 grit. That's why you put the vinyl sealer on it, to start building that finish from the wood up. If you're going to be using a varnish or a stain or hand rubbing a shellac or something, then you wouldn't want to use the vinyl. But for the way I'm going to finish this, vinyl sealer. The neck. I took the neck down to 400 and then I rubbed Danish oil in. Gotten where I prefer to use Danish oil on the neck. It provides protection almost as good as a satin lacquer or gloss lacquer, but it retains the raw wood feel. A lot of times when you have, especially a gloss lacquer, your hand will kind of rub, skip, you can, it kind of gets in your way. Not, doesn't get in my way, but if you're a fast player and you're up and down the neck, you'll know what I'm talking about. That's why they started going to the satin gloss, I mean satin clear coat, because it's not as sticky when you're going up and down the neck. Some people sand them down, some people wax them, all kinds of different theories on it, people doing different things. I found that two or three good coats of Danish oil. We'll really sink well into the grain. It makes the grain almost not quite like a torrefied wood grain, but it does harden the grain up. Then I can take it down to about some 3000 grit, and it looks like it has been sprayed with a high gloss lacquer, but it does not feel like that. It feels like it's a raw wood neck. So I just wanted to give you a quick update, talk to you about sanding, and let you know how I'm coming along on it. Really digging it. I'm very pleased with this body, which is such a relief after this whole Warmoth stuff, which I still have not got my refund, but I'm moving on. I'm moving past it. So I'm going to hit this with the vinyl sealer, about two coats, and then we'll come back and we will talk about getting it ready for the actual color, and we'll talk about our paints a little bit. Thanks for checking me out. Any questions, comments, concerns, please just let me know. Got something you want me to cover, let me know that too. We'll do it.